Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you all are hale and hearty. Well, I'm Satinder Kaur and today I'll be taking up Lesson 8 from Social and Political Life for Class 6. And the name of the lesson is Rural Livelihoods. In this lesson, we'll look at different ways in which people earn their living in villages and also talk about the similarities in their life situations and the problems they face. We shall also examine whether people in the rural areas have equal opportunities to earn a living. So children, let me take you to Kalpattu village in Tamil Nadu. The village is close to the sea coast, and as in other villages, people in Kalpattu village too are engaged in different kinds of work. Apart from farm work, people are engaged in non-farm work such as making baskets, utensils, pots, bricks, bullock carts, etc. There are people who provide services such as blacksmiths, nurses, teachers, washermen, weavers, barbers, cycle repair mechanics, and so on. There are also some shopkeepers and traders. In the main street, which looks like a bazaar, you will find a variety of small shops such as tea shops, grocery shops, barber shops, a cloth shop, a tailor, and two fertilizer and seed shops. There are four tea shops which sell tiffin such as idli, dosa and upma in the morning, and snacks like vada, bonda and Mysore pak in the evening. Near the tea shops in a corner lives a blacksmith family whose home serves as their workshop. Next to their home is a cycle hire and repair shop. Two families earn a living by washing clothes. There are some people who go to the nearby town to work as construction workers and lorry drivers. The village is surrounded by low hills. Paddy is the main crop that is grown in irrigated lands. Most of the families earn a living through agriculture. There are some coconut groves around. Cotton, sugarcane, and plantain are also grown, and there are mango orchards. Let us now meet some people who work in the fields in Kalpattu and see what we can learn about farming from them. Let's meet Tulasi first and see what she has to say. All of us here work on Ramalingam's land. He has 20 acres of paddy fields in Kalpattu. Even before I was married, I used to work on paddy fields in my parental village. I work from 8:30 in the morning till 4:30 in the evening. And Karuthamma, Ramalingam's wife, supervises us. This is one of the few times in the year that I find regular work. Now I am transplanting the paddy. When the plants have grown a bit, Ramalingam will call us again for weeding and then finally once again for the harvesting. When I was young, I could do this work with no difficulty. But now, as I grow older, I find bending for long hours with my feet in water very painful. Ramalingam pays rupees 40 per day. This is a little less than what laborers get in my home village. But I come here because I can depend on him to call me whenever there is work. Unlike others, he does not go looking for cheaper labor from other villages. My husband Raman is also a laborer. We don't own any land. During this time of the year, he sprays pesticides. When there is no work on the farm, he finds work outside, either loading sand from the river or stone from the quarry nearby. This is sent by truck to be used in nearby towns to make houses. Apart from working on the land, I do all the tasks at home. I cook food for my family, clean the house and wash clothes. I go with other women to the nearby forest to collect firewood. About 1 kilometer away, we have a village borewell from where I fetch water. My husband helps in getting materials such as groceries for the house. Our school-going daughters are the joy of our lives. Last year, one of them fell ill and had to be taken to the hospital in town. We had to sell our cow to pay back the money we borrowed from Ramalingam for her treatment. Children, as you saw in Tulasi's story, poor families in rural areas often spend a lot of time every day collecting firewood, getting water and grazing their cattle. Even though they do not earn any money from these activities, they have to do them for the household. The family needs to spend time doing this as they are not able to survive on the little money they earn. Nearly two-fifths of all rural families are agricultural laborers in our country. There are some who have small plots of land while others like Tulasi are landless. Not being able to earn money throughout the year forces people in many rural areas to travel long distances in search of work. This travel or migration takes place during particular seasons. Now, let's meet a small farmer, Shekhar, and see what he has to say. We have to carry this paddy to our house. My family has just finished harvesting our field. We don't own much land, only 2 acres. We manage to do all the work on our own. At times, especially during the harvest, I take the help of other small farmers and in turn help them harvest their field. The trader gave me seeds and fertilizers as a loan. To pay back this loan, I have to sell my paddy to him at a somewhat lower price than what I would get in the market. He has sent his agent to remind farmers who have taken loans that they will sell the paddy only to him. I will probably get 60 bags of paddy from my field. Some of this I will sell to settle the loan, the rest will be used in my home. But whatever I have will last only 8 months. So I need to earn some money. I work in Ramalingam's rice mill. Here I help him collect paddy from other farmers in the neighboring villages. We have a hybrid cow whose milk we sell in the local milk cooperative. This way we get a little extra money for our everyday needs. Children, as you have just seen, very often farmers like Shekhar need to borrow money to purchase basic things like seeds, fertilizers and pesticides. Often they borrow this money from moneylenders. If the seeds are not of good quality or pests attack their crop, there can be a major crop failure. The crops can also be ruined if the monsoon does not bring enough rain. When this happens, farmers sometimes are unable to pay back their loans. And for the family to survive, they may even have to borrow more money. Soon, the loan becomes so large that no matter what they earn, they are unable to repay. And this is when we can say they are caught in debt. In recent years, this has become a major cause of distress among farmers. In some areas, this has also resulted in many farmers committing suicide. And this is very unfortunate, isn't it, children? Children, You have seen that Ramalingam is a large farmer. He owns a lot of land. In addition to land, Ramalingam's family owns a rice mill and a shop selling seeds, pesticides, etc. For the rice mill, they used some of their own money and also borrowed from the government bank. They buy paddy from within the village and from the surrounding villages. The rice that is produced in the mill is sold to traders in nearby towns. This gives them a substantial income. So children, now we'll talk about agricultural laborers and farmers in India. In Kalpattu village, there are agricultural laborers like Tulasi and many small farmers like Shekhar and a few big farmers like Ramalingam. In India, nearly 2 out of every 5 rural families are agricultural laborer families. All of them depend on the work they do on other people's fields to earn a living. Many of them are landless and others may own very small plots of land. In the case of small farmers like Shekhar, their land is barely enough to meet their needs. In India, 80% of farmers belong to this group. Only 20% of India's farmers are like Ramalingam. These large farmers cultivate most of the land in the villages. A large part of their produce is sold in the market. Many of them have started other businesses such as shops, money lending, trading, small factories, etc. We have looked at farming in Kalpattu. Apart from farming, many people in rural areas depend upon collection from the forest, animal husbandry, dairy produce, fishing, etc. For example, in some villages in central India, both farming and collection from the forest are important sources of livelihood. Collecting mahua, tendu leaves, honey to be sold to traders is an important source of additional income. Similarly, selling milk to the village cooperative society or taking milk to the nearby town may be the main source of livelihood for some families. In the coastal areas, we find fishing villages. Let's now talk about the life of a fishing family that lives in Pudupet, a village close to Kalpattu. Aruna and Parivelan belong to a fishing family. Now let's hear Aruna about what they do to earn their living and what difficulties are faced by them. My husband Parivelan, my brother and my brother-in-law returned late today. I was very worried. They go to the sea together in our catamaran. They said they were caught in a storm. I have kept aside some fish for the family. I will auction the rest. The money I get from the auction will be divided into 4 shares, one each for each person who went fishing, and the 4th one is for the equipment. Since we own the catamaran, engine and nets, we get that share too. We have taken a loan from a bank and purchased an engine which is fixed onto the catamaran. Now they can go far into the sea so that they can get a better catch. The women who buy fish here will carry them in baskets to be sold in nearby villages. Then there are others like traders who buy for the shops in the town. I'll only finish this auction by noon. In the evening, my husband and our relatives will untangle and repair our nets. Early tomorrow morning, around 2 a.m., they will set out to sea again. Every year, for at least about 4 months during the monsoon, they cannot go to the sea because this is when the fish breed. During these months, we survive by borrowing from the trader. Because of this, later on we are forced to sell the fish to that trader and cannot do our auction. Those lean months are the most difficult. Last year we suffered a lot because of the tsunami. So children, that was all about rural livelihoods. People in rural areas earn their living in various ways. Some work on farms while others earn their living on non-farm activities. Working on farms involves operations such as preparing the land, sowing, weeding, and harvesting of crops. We depend on nature for the growth of these crops. Hence, life revolves around certain seasons. People are busy during sowing and harvesting and less so at other times. Rural people in different regions of the country grow different crops. However, we do find some similarities in their life situations. How people are able to survive or earn will depend upon the land that they cultivate. Many depend on these lands for work as laborers. Most farmers grow crops both for their own requirement and also to sell in the market. Some have to sell to traders from whom they have borrowed money. For their survival, many families need to borrow money for their work or when no work is available. There are some families in rural areas which thrive on large acres of land, business and other activities. However, most small farmers, agricultural laborers, fishing families, craft persons in the villages do not find enough work to keep them employed throughout the year. So children, with this we come to the end of today's lesson. I hope you all understood it well. Now it's time to take up a few questions to see how much you have understood. First, we have some multiple choice questions and you have to choose the correct option. The first question is, where is Kalpattu located? And the options are Tamil Nadu, Delhi, Karnal or Mumbai. And the correct option is, yes, Tamil Nadu. The second question is, what is the main crop of Kalpattu village? And the options are paddy, wheat, sweet corn or sugar cane. And the correct option is paddy. Very good. Now let's move ahead and take up the third question. What does Ramalingam do with the rice produced in his rice mills? And the options are, he distributes it among the poor people, he sells it to traders in nearby towns, he sells it to the government, or he sells it to the villagers. And the correct option is, he sells it to the traders in nearby towns. Now let's take up the fourth question. Who was Tulasi? And the options are, agricultural laborer, contractor, farmer or trader. And the correct option is, yes, agricultural laborer. Now let's take up the last question. Which of the following is not a source of livelihood in rural areas? And the options are selling milk, fishing, selling goods in malls or farming. And the correct option is, yes, selling goods in malls. Children, now we have some sentences and you have to tell whether these sentences are true or false. And the first sentence is, nearly 2/5 of all rural families are agricultural laborers in our country. And this sentence is true. The second sentence is, weaving is a farm activity. Is it true, children? No, it is false, because weaving is a non-farm activity. Let's take up the third sentence. Shekhar takes loan from bank and buys seeds and fertilizers. This sentence is again false because Shekhar does not take loan from bank to buy seeds and fertilizers. Rather, the village trader gives him seeds and fertilizers as a loan. Now, let's take up the last sentence. Tulasi sold her cow to pay back the money she borrowed from Ramalingam for her daughter's treatment. And this sentence is true. Very good. So, children, with this, we come to the end of today's video. I'm sure you liked it and got to know a great deal about the various ways in which people in rural areas earn their living. In the next lesson, we shall talk about different kinds of work people do in urban areas. That's all for today. I'll be back with some more interesting videos. Till then, stay healthy, stay happy.